The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Jews quarrel among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink the blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, unlike your ancestor who ate and still died. Whoever eats this bread will live forever." These things he said while teaching in the synagogue in Capernaum. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Minsan sa buhay natin, meron tayo mga plano. Mga plano for our dream, for our achievement. And we think our plano is the best plano, the best plan that are we prepared. But sometimes, we cannot accept that along the way, there are changes. There are the changes that we need to change our plan. And we end up with frustration or sadness. But remember, when we change our plan, it's not the end of everything. While I read and reflect on the first reading today, the story of Saul and Ananias, I remember a charismatic song. A title is, "God Will Make a Way." God will make a way. And I think that this song is fit for Saul and for Ananias. God really make a way for both of them. In the part of Saul, we know Saul is the Jews and have a plan to kill the Christian. He go to Damascus to kill and to find the Christian. But what happened? His plan is changed. His plan is changed because God have another plan for him. Also, what happened with Ananias? Sa palagay ko, when Ananias hear the message from the Lord to came to Saul, pwede siya bargain with God, no? "Ay Lord, ako pa yung pupunta kay Saul? Eh alam ko nga eh, si Saul ay papatay ng tao. Ako pa? Bakit ako pupunta sa kanya?" Parang sweet sight para sa kanya, no? Parang he will kill himself when he meet Saul. But everything changed. Ananias fulfilled the message of the Lord. He came to meet Saul. And what happened? Ananias became the instrument of the change of Paul. Once again, no, mga kapatid, kung may plano si Lord, may paraan din siya. May paraan siya sa buhay natin. Kung we look in ourselves, the experience of Paul and Ananias is our experience also. Sometimes we questioning God, "God, tama ba ito? God, ito ba para sa atin?" Mga kapatid, paalala lang. Kung may plano si Lord, may paraan siya para sa atin. Hindi na hindi siya iwanan sa atin. Yung plano niya is fit for us. Yung plano niya is the best for us. Don't be afraid, mga kapatid, when we have a change of plan. Remember, our Lord is bigger than our problem. Kung siya may paraan, He will fulfill and will help us to finish our plan. That's why, when I remember again that song, God will make a way. God will make a way where there seem to be no way. He works in way we cannot see. He will make a way for you and for me. Amen.